targeted social services through JSIF and the RGD, increased community engagement through the JIS, and greater push towards projects ripe for job creation and economic growth.
Now is the time for action.
Watch as Minister Without Portfolio in the office of the Prime Minister, Mike Henry, unveils his plans to help build a new Jamaica in 2019-2020.
We cannot build a country without uplifting the more vulnerable elements of the society.
That's why the Jamaica Social Investment Fund has earmarked $8.4 billion for national development. In 2019-2020, work will continue on the youth employment in the digital and animation industries YETI project, as well as the community renewal program in 100 volatile and vulnerable areas. Similar intervention will continue in the Mount Salem and Denham Town zones of special operations. Programs in community renewal, disaster vulnerability reduction, integrated community development, poverty reduction, and the Basic Needs Trust will also be undertaken. Over at the Registrar General's Department, work processes are being re-engineered to better serve customers. The digitizing of over 7 million records is ongoing. An electronic database with supporting software is being expanded, and a complaints management system has been implemented at the department's call center. The RGD will also embark on an electronic production system for birth, death, and marriages.
The current system will be modified to include image management. Eliminate the need for physical vital records when processing applications. The records will no longer be required to leave the vault and the verification of information.
The Culture, Health, Arts, Sports and Education Chase Fund will also provide funding for priority areas in 2019-2020. Among them, $57 million towards the establishment of a 16-bed high-dependency unit at the Kingston Public Hospital. $50 million has been set aside to construct space to house social needs patients from the Savannah Lamar Hospital on the property of the Westmoreland Infirmary. Chase has also budgeted money to install water harvesting and sanitation systems in 5 schools that still use pit latrines.
The project includes the upgrading construction of toilet facilities, installation of rainwater harvesting dams, installation of gutters, and over 1,000 students are slated to benefit from the consequent improved health and hygiene.
The official public information and communications arm of the government will also be broadening its scope in 2019-2020 in a bid to highlight the range of activities being undertaken by the state and give greater access to government services. The Jamaica Information Service will be hosting a series of community meetings.
The forum will create opportunities for citizens to address ministers and other government officials as they air concerns and share ideas. It will also provide the avenue for government to listen and offer explanations and assurance, as well as take on board ideas from the communities.
The JIS will also be partnering with the Public Broadcasting Corporation of Jamaica, PBCJ, to produce a series of panel discussions focused on the state's plans, policies, and programs. A program to digitize the JIS's archives is ongoing. So too is the drive to become ISO 9001 2015 certified. Minister Henry is also focusing on large-scale investments that have the capacity to bring even greater economic growth to the island. By early 2020, Phase 1 of the Jamaica Gansu Industrial Park project is expected to be completed. That phase will see the rehabilitation and upgrading of the existing power plant and refinery at Alpart.
The railway from the plant to the port is being upgraded. The port will be refurbished to accommodate an increased level of aluminum production, which will be necessary to drive the anchor facilities of the industrial park.
Work is moving apace on the Vernon Field Aerotropolis project. A final report is being awaited for the design and plan for the cost and rehabilitation of the main runway at Vernon Field. While those works continue, private lands are being acquired, leaking water mains are being repaired, and power lines are being rerouted.
Work on the community roads are due to commence later this month, and a completion of the road repairs, traffic into Gimimibit will no longer have to use the runway to access the district. Once the community road is repaired, the runway will be closed to vehicular traffic to facilitate the runway rehabilitation.
As government pursues larger scale investments, strides are now being made to explore possibilities in deep seabed mining. Government has endorsed a Jamaican company's application to scour the seabed for polymetallic nodules, which are rich in nickel, copper, cobalt, and manganese.
It's a cost-efficient enterprise which does not involve drilling or blasting, as the nodules are lying on the surface of the seabed and are harvested by collector through hydraulic suction.
Concrete actions are being taken by Minister Mike Henry to achieve the government's vision of a new Jamaica.